how dare you say this? How dare you say this? Now put him behind the bars. How could you say this? And so he was punished and he was put in the jail. And in those days, the hobby of the kids was to go to the jungle for hunting. So he went for hunting there. And then because his minister was not there, some others accompanied him and they couldn't, you know, cope with the king. And so in the forest, the king was left back somewhere and the king was somewhere. And then there, they were, we call it as Adivasis, the natives of that land. And they were celebrating some festival there. And for that festival, they had to sacrifice a human being. And they were looking for a human being. And because they were the natives of the that land, they never knew that this person was the king and anything. So as soon as they saw the king, they attacked him and they tied him. And you know the rituals, there were so many rituals and everything going on. And finally, he was about to, they were about to sacrifice, put him in the this one. And then immediately, they saw the bandage in the little finger. You know, the rule says, if there is any cut or anything in the body, the God will not accept it. So immediately what they did was, they released the king. Now where would the king go?
The minister.
He wouldn't go to the palace. He went to the jail and he was sorry and asked him to forgive. And then he released the minister. And so both of them, they are coming. And then said, now I understood the meaning of your words. Whatever happens, happens for good. Please forgive me, I'm very sorry. That I didn't understand and I just put you behind the bus. And then the king said, I have a confusion. I have a confusion. That okay, for me, it saved my life. Your words saved my life. But what about you? I put you behind the bars for no reason. And how did, what good is there in that? So he said, I don't have any cut in my body. If I, everything was okay, then I would have accompanied you and the natives would. And I would not leave you like that, like the other team. So I'll always be with you. And then the natives would have seen and attacked us. And then as soon as they see the bandage, they would have relieved you and I would have lost my life. So it's good for me to be behind the bars and it's good for you to have a cut in the little finger. So in every situation, there is always a direct or indirect benefit. For the king, it was a direct benefit, and for the minister, it was an indirect benefit. So in every situation, we need to see either directly or indirectly, there will be some benefit, right? And we just, sometimes it's not seen. It may take time. It may take time, but we need to wait. Okay? So in every situation, there is always some direct or indirect benefit. And the other thing is, if you just want to overcome all these challenges very easily, then the best thing is we need to help others in the terms that money, you know, we need to help others do something good to others, which money can't replace that. Then you will have that strength, you will have that confidence to do good, and with no reason you will be happy. You will be happy because of the accumulation of your punya karma. So that we need to do, otherwise it won't work out. We need some strength. And like our own karma is like traffic. And the little kid wants to cross the road. He doesn't know the traffic rules. So what will he do? He'll go half of the road and somewhere it listens to the horn sound or something, or the some sound of a vehicle. Immediately, what will the kid do? Without saying, it will come back. It will run and it comes back. And again it will go a little further, again it will listen to the vehicle sound, again it will run back, it will come back. But the same kid is holding the hand of the mother or father. Very easily, without any worries, very easily it will cross the road. So the karma is like a traffic. You can't change that. But we have an option. We can hold the hand of God. So when we are holding our parent, if we hold the parent's hand, then easily we can cross all the challenges, all the situations. But still, the karma is there, the traffic is there on the road, but I can overcome very easily the love for God. If I have that love for God,